gusto aquí en Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Mota. Y estamos, como le decía, esta semana estuvimos en North Carolina, cerca de Raleigh, probando el nuevo Lexus IS 2014. Lexus por fin le ha sacado lo mucho de Toyota que había en sus autos, y en el Lexus IS tiene un diseño muy atractivo por fuera, pero sobre todo por dentro. Me parece que ahí es donde ha mejorado más el auto. Lexus ha estado, hablábamos en el segmento anterior de los premios Toro Quarterly 2013, y Lexus siempre ha estado en los primeros lugares en ese y en muchos otros estudios, porque los autos francamente son muy buenos, tienen una confiabilidad, duran mucho. Pero en cuestión de diseño habían estado un poco, se habían quedado un poco atrás, me parece, en cuanto a la competencia. Y por fin ahora, desde ya hace un año, han empezaron con el GS, que fue el primer modelo que tiene esa parrilla en doble trapecio invertido, que realmente es atractiva. Y ahora el IS, el modelo de entrada, digamos, del segmento de lujo, donde compite con el BMW Serie 3, el Mercedes-Benz C-Class, y ahora también con el Cadillac ATS, que en realidad desde que salió hace el año pasado ha estado teniendo grandes cifras de ventas y está dándole gran competencia. Así que estuvimos allá en North Carolina, como les decía, y vamos a escuchar la entrevista con Owen Peacock, que es el Product Marketing Manager de Lexus para Estados Unidos, y nos va a hablar no solamente del auto, sino también de todo lo que está haciendo Lexus para tratar de atraer más consumidores y sobre todo darles el servicio que se espera de una marca de lujo, y sobre todo, como decíamos, poder estar a la altura de la competencia, que es mucha y muy buena. Así que vamos a escuchar la entrevista con Owen Peacock de Lexus.
So Owen, thank you very much for having us here. We're in Rockingham. What's the name of the Speedway? Rockingham Speedway, yeah, yeah. North Carolina, the new IS 2014, third generation for this car, and basically a new car, right?
Yeah, this is the all new IS. So this will actually be one of the main cars that we've got for Lexus. That's really exciting. It's got our brand new spindle grille. It's the most aggressive expression of that new spindle grille, which is kind of our new signature look, yeah, for the front end of the car.
That comes from the LFA, right, originally?
Some of the design cues come from, yeah, the LFA. I think what you'll see with the Lexus brand overall is we're really passionate about design. So you first saw the spindle grille on the GS when it came out a little, mm-hmm, over a year ago. Now it's carrying through all of our models, and the IS is the latest car to get it.
Yeah. And the outside looks completely different, but the inside, I think, is even more different than the previous generation. With no offense or anything, but like the previous designs interior-wise weren't as good as this one.
Yeah, this new one, again, you know, going after design, as well as driver convenience, driver comfort, has been a real key. So the minute you get in the car, you can easily see where everything's been positioned. So with just extending your arm, you can reach all the controls. It's not uncomfortable to do that. With your eyes, you really don't have to take them off the road all that much, yeah, to see all the information that's going on with your car, whether it's something as simple as looking how many miles you've driven or looking at something like the nav screen. It's all really within reach of both your eyes and arms.
Yeah, and also the selection of materials, the combination, it's just really nice. I mean, you can, everything you touch, you look, you smell, it's pretty nice, like a complete upgrade from last generation.
And that's really important, to deliver a complete car, a complete package. Just because you change the outside doesn't, yeah, mean you ignore the inside, and we haven't. So really we want to make this, again, a complete experience, both inside the car, outside the car, and when you're buying the car.
Yeah, and especially because the competition has getting tougher, right? I mean, like the Cadillac ATS, the BMW for sure, I mean, that's the classic leading this segment and all that. So it's getting more competition, yeah, more and better.
This is the near entry luxury segment, and this is probably one of the most competitive segments in there. So, you know, there's been steadfast competitors in there for a while. We've got some new entries in there. IS has been in there. This is its third generation, and we're really confident that this latest generation of the IS is really going to be one that's going to compete for leadership within that segment.
Yeah, and Lexus has always been, and it's always ranked very high in every study of the industry, consumer satisfaction, reliability, and all those things. But you're still also like putting more effort into that, especially customer service.
Yeah, we've actually got two new positions, relatively new positions at the dealerships. One is our Lexus delivery specialists, who really customize the vehicle delivery. So you've saved your money, you've spent your money, you've enjoyed the car, now you want to get it delivered to you, and really it's about customizing how you want it delivered. The second position that we've got at our dealership.
Let me go back to that one. That's like while people are ordering the car, or they or when they already have ordered the car and they get the possession of it and like learn, because there's a lot of technology in the car.
And that's really key. So, you know, usually there's this thing of where you spent all this time buying the car, you just want to get out of there, get in your new car and drive away. Well, there's so much technology in the car and so many cool features that we really want to make it an experience of where you look forward to that delivery. So you just want to get the keys and get the heck out of there. We want you to say, you know what, maybe I'll even come back tomorrow and spend 2 hours taking delivery so I can really understand everything that's going on with my car.
So and the other one is the tech specialist?
Yeah, the other one is the Lexus, what we call the Lexus technology specialist. And what we're really seeing today in the marketplace for cars is this meeting of technology in your life with the car technology. So smartphones, as we all know, have so much technology. Well, that's really being integrated now into the car. So whether it's you want to make a reservation through OpenTable, you want to search something on Bing, you want to listen to your favorite Pandora radio station, there's so much technology that we really do need to do a service to our customers and educate them on how to integrate it seamlessly into the car. So it's not a problem, it's actually a real big benefit.
Yeah. So people can come in, customers can and get the car, let's say, on a Friday, go over the weekend, and then come back on Monday to whenever the next week, and like, okay, can you explain me this, and that's part of the service?
Yeah, absolutely. So again, it's about whatever the customer wants, we just want to tailor that experience to them. So from a convenience standpoint, from a no-hassle standpoint, but you're right, maybe they drove away, and all of a sudden, 4 days later, they have a question. They can come in and ask their delivery specialist or ask their technology specialist. And these people aren't primarily salespeople. They're there really to service the customer. So these people do have, you know, the expertise and the knowledge to really help you out.
And yeah, you were mentioning in your presentation that this has brought a lot of younger employees and like more tech savvy employees to your dealership, which also opens up different doors for you inside and out, right?
Yeah, so imagine someone who's working at, let's say, a retail technology store, a Best Buy or something like that. They already know the technical aspect of technology and smartphones and things of that nature. So what we've really done is tapped into that type of a workforce and said, hey, why don't you come and do that same type of thing, but in the dealership environment. So it's given them an opportunity, plus it's given us an opportunity to have new people come in and be a Lexus associate that we may not have talked to in the past.
Yeah. So these two, the new generation, two models, IS250 and IS350, right?
Yeah, we have the IS250, we have the IS350. They come in different variants. So you can get rear-wheel drive, you can get all-wheel drive, or you can step up to what we call F-Sport. And the F-Sport grade is really a more performance-oriented edition of the car. And really what's cool is when you get into that IS350 F-Sport, which is a fantastic car, fantastic powertrain, the neat thing is what we call, it's a meter in there that's carried down from the LFA. So anyone who's familiar with the LFA supercar, the minute you get in there, you will recognize that meter.
Not many people have gone into an LFA because there are so few of them.
Yeah, a lot more people have access to the meter and the IS than they will in an LFA, that's for sure.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much again for your time and for having us here. We're going to keep enjoying driving the car here around the track and then go back to the beautiful hotel.
All right, let's keep on enjoying this car.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Pues esa fue la entrevista sobre el nuevo Lexus IS 2014, un auto que realmente me gustó mucho, no solamente como decía el diseño exterior, el interior, el manejo, estuvimos probándolo en la pista de Rockingham Speedway allá en North Carolina y realmente el auto se maneja súper bien, obviamente el 250 que es un motor más pequeño no tiene la misma respuesta del 350 que es espectacular cuando se maneja en la pista. Vamos a colocar una serie de videos también ahí en nuestro canal de YouTube, lo pueden buscar Auto 060 en YouTube y ahí van a poder ver exactamente lo que estamos hablando. Rápidamente, antes de que se acabe el segmento, una nueva lista de Kelley Blue Book, que siempre saca listas muy interesantes. Estas son las mejores SUVs 2013 por menos de $25,000. Y la voy a decir rápido, pero también la colocamos en Facebook y en nuestra página para que lo vean. Honda CR-V, número 1, la Mazda CX-5 en el número 2, Ford Escape, número 3, la Toyota RAV4, totalmente rediseñada para este año, en el número 4, y lo que hablábamos antes, Kia y Hyundai en el lugar 5 y 6, con la Kia Sorento y la Hyundai Santa Fe Sport. También la Subaru Forester en el número 7, otro modelo que fue totalmente rediseñado. En el número 8 está la Jeep Wrangler, el modelo también del grupo Chrysler que habíamos hablado antes de cómo han subido en su calidad. Y cómo están trayendo productos nuevos y mucho más interesantes y atractivos para el público. En el número 9, la Volkswagen T1, una SUV compacta. Y en el número 10, la Buick Encore, también un modelo de lujo, de la división de lujo de General Motors. Completa el top 10 de las mejores SUVs 2013 por menos de $25,000, que fue compilada por Kelley Blue Book. Y esto no solamente incluye el valor inicial del auto, sino también está en consideración el valor residual después de haber tenido y mantenido el auto durante 5 años. Y también algo muy importante que siempre se debe tener en cuenta a la hora de tomar la decisión de comprar el auto: cuánto cuesta tener y mantener el auto. Les doy un ejemplo simplemente, por ejemplo, aquí en la Honda CR-V, que cuesta menos de $25,000, pero el costo de tenerla y mantenerla durante 5 años llega a $35,336, y el valor residual después de ese periodo son apenas $12,140. Así que muchos números, mucha información, lo ponemos en facebook.com/auto060 para que la puedan analizar y quizá se puedan dar una ayuda a la hora de decidir qué auto van a comprar, si es que están en ese proceso en estos momentos. No se vayan, que cuando regresemos vamos a hablar con Ross Rader del Instituto de Seguridad en las Carreteras para hablar de una nueva iniciativa que tienen. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota. We'll be right back.